Okay, Kobe doing work. 2-4 on my shirt. He the greatest on the court, and I'm the greatest on the verse. Going for the fourth ring like it was his first. Gotta get the gleam. Do it for Kareem. 2-4 so nice. My flow so mean. Catch me at the game, sitting next to Goldstein. Kobe Bryant Nikes, purple gold strings. Kobe in the game, dunking on
the whole team.
Black Mamba, attack conquer. Basketball beast, rap monster. Crossover good, a turnaround jumper. I'll just drive the lane and dunk on the dunkers. You know where it's going down, yo. This is the lake show, but don't drown, though. I call him King Bryant, not let the crown show.
Black Lives Matter fact, as a matter of fact.
What's happening, guys? James G back at it again with another review, and we're taking a look at NBA 2K24 from 2K. And you know what? I love basketball. I love these games. They're always a lot of fun, but this year, there's something about 2K24, and I just can't put my finger on it. Yes, I can. It's stuck behind such a massive VC paywall on a lot of these game modes, which I hate. I wish there was an easier way to grind VC. I wish there was an easier way to upgrade my player, especially in my city and my career. But don't get me wrong. 2K24 is still a fun game if you're a huge basketball fan. The game plays well. The graphics are amazing as always. The game is a little bit more fluid this year. Some cool animations they've added with the pro play where it's like likeness from actual player movements and everything from the NBA, which is really, really cool that they've done that. Defense feels great. The AI seems a lot better this year. So 2K has nailed it on a lot of these cool enhancements that they've done, but they've also kind of kept us behind in that VC paywall. And I'll talk about that a little bit later as I'm talking about some of the modes, but I want to jump in to some of the key modes that I really, you know, really played a lot of in this. And you're seeing some of my team play right here, and some 3v3 on the blacktop as well. And then I'm gonna jump right into my favorite mode, which was definitely the Mamba moments, where you're progressing through Kobe Bryant's career and some of these monumental games that he played. And I love how 2K has implemented the, you know, real in life footage that they've done, in-game footage, and then they've got this amazing CGI cutscenes that you're seeing here in the background that just brings this story and this and then Kobe likeness to life. And I love it. RIP Kobe, he's one of the greats. And you, last year you had the MJ story, now you've got Kobe, so it's really good. And obviously next year you're probably gonna get LeBron, but who cares, right? I'm not a big LeBron fan, gotta say it right now. MJ for life. But I love how they've done this with Kobe. Some really, really cool game modes here to play through, and some of the key moments in his career. And obviously one of my favorites was here when he dropped all those threes on the Seattle Supersonics, and you're seeing that gameplay right now. So well done, 2K. I love how you implemented this, and I hope they continue to do that. And they've done it with like WWE games as well, adding the storylines in there. And I love how that gives like offline players like myself some fun things to play. Let's jump into my team. Some enhancements in my team this year too. There's a salary cap mode. There's a lot of variations of acquiring XP, but you know, there's still that VC paywall. Like I keep mentioning, you're going to be stuck behind it. If you want to be playing online, you need to actually spend money to compete with some of these guys who have the most insane rosters out there. So if you're someone that doesn't want to spend money and you want to grind it out, go for it. The grind is insane. If this is a game you just play by yourself, and you're just, that's the only game you play, you're gonna have fun with it because you can be able to grind it out. But there is a massive paywall, and that is very evident when you're playing in my city and the career. It just seems like a more insane grind this year. But the city looks great. Love it's got that Miami Vice GTA kind of vibe to it. The career and the story mode is your typical, you know, you're the star, and this year you're still MP and your dad was a basketball player, your grandfather, and you're just following in their footsteps. Story works well. There's some key game features that you can play where it's just key games that you're playing through your career to move things along faster. But 2K is nailed it. The graphics is still good. The city is still fun. You know, like me, I like to play in it. It's still the grind, which unfortunately is really bad this year. You know, I've got the Kobe edition, and I got the 100K VC, and I'm still at level like 78 or whatever it is as my player is progressing. But 2K still nailed it here. Still a lot of fun. If you like the grind, go for it. Some cool offline modes. You got the WNBA mode. There's eras, which I love. So you can compete in seasons and everything from different eras, like the Kobe era, MJ, and LeBron. They just added that as well, too. So some really cool features and some cool offline modes that you can play as well. Have your buddies over, have some fun and quick play, and do all that if you want. Play on the blacktop, whatever. It's really cool. And like I said, the menu is a lot easier this year. a lot more, you know, more in your face and a lot easier to navigate through there. But still, it's just that VC wall for me. I wish they would change that up a little bit and allow some easier access to the VC and enable us to upgrade your player when you're playing on my team or my city and everything like that. But overall, the gameplay is great. Like, don't get me wrong, 2K always brings it here. They've always made an amazing sports game, and NBA 2K24 is nothing different. The game is great. Graphics are amazing. Gameplay is there. The AI is there. Some of the pro play animations that they've added and these errors that they've added is a lot of fun to play. And don't get me wrong, the city is still fun to play. I just wish that, the VC paywall was gone and you didn't have to drop tons of money on the game to actually become better. But overall, 2K still nails it here for me. I'm going to have to give it like a 6.5, 7 out of 10 this year. But I love what they've done with the Mamba Moments. Some key features here that have been added to the game. So rest in peace, Kobe, once again. That's your review for NBA 2K24. If you're a big basketball fan, don't sleep on this game. It's still a lot of fun to play. Just that VC paywall's got to go. James G, Next Level Gaming. We'll catch you guys in the next review. Cheers.